YouTube?
Not YouTube. The let me see that Teddy Riley thing. The let me see what it is.
Oh yeah, we produced that. What's this regarding?
No, I just want to know if how do we go about with that?
How do you go about with what?
The information, it says the reality TV show. Is this just something of his? I see the telephone number, or is he like advertising it for? Actually, I was trying to find out. Was that something that we walk into that that maybe they're boy, I'm saying the wrong thing. You know, when you're interested in
I'm not certain what you're looking for.
I was trying to find out. Actually, I probably got the wrong number. I needed to go on the other line.
The other line? What line is that?
Not the other line. Probably go online. You know how they have the information online? He has other information online. I was trying to find out where what you call him was down. I know it's downtown somewhere, but I'm not exactly sure.
You're looking for a location?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. What's your name?
Simone.
Simone. Okay, yeah. Hey, I take calls because we're a Christian company. Would you consider yourself a Christian, Simone?
Yes.
Okay. And then if you're a Christian, do you know 100% sure that you'll be in heaven when it's your time?
I hope so.
So you're not 100% sure?
I hope so.
Okay, well, I'm just saying, I want to know if that's 100% or 90%, 50%, where you at with that?
Maybe, I don't know.
Oh, okay.
Maybe 100%, maybe 90, I don't know, I'm not sure.
Okay, so you're not 100% sure. All right, well, no, just...
We're not perfect, but I don't know.
Yeah, well, it's not about being perfect. You know what the Bible says, how you can know 100% sure is you need to know Jesus. Do you know Jesus as your Savior?
Yes.
You do. So you're familiar with the gospel that Jesus Christ is God that came in the flesh. He put himself in the womb of Mary as a virgin. And then he was born into the world. And he walked this life, lived a perfect life, never sinned. You and I have sinned, but he never sinned. And then he died on the cross. He went up on the cross and took on us and became sin who knew no sin. And when he was on the cross, what he did is he actually shed his blood. You know, the Bible tells us that the life of the flesh is in the blood. So in order for us to have life, we needed his life out of his blood. So that was the purpose of him shedding the blood. It paid the price for all of our sins. And he didn't stay dead, though. He arose on the third day as he promised. He promised that he would arise on the third day. So he arose from the dead. And now he has the keys to life and death. And so he's saying that the only way that you can go to heaven is through him because he has the keys. So have you believed on that gospel message of Jesus Christ that he is the only way and he's God and that only through him can you get to heaven?
Okay.
Have you believed on that?
Yeah, I believe that.
Amen. Well, if you believe on that and you confess that Jesus is your Savior, not yourself. See, we as human beings, we all try to do it ourselves. We try to be good and earn our way to heaven, but we can't. We're sinners. We've all fallen short of the glory of God. So it says in Romans 10:9, it says that whosoever shall confess the Lord Jesus, thou shalt be saved. So are you confessing, are you confessing Jesus as your Savior?
Yeah, I believe him. I believe he is.
Okay, so let me ask you this then. If God were to say, why should he let you into heaven, what would you say?
Because I believe he's the Christ, right?
Who's the Christ?
Jesus, right?
That's right. That's the only way you can get into heaven. Trust on that, believe on that, and then walk on that. You receive that through faith. Because you faithfully believe the gospel that I preached to you, And that's how you become saved. And now share that same gospel with your friends and family. Do you know if your family is saved? Do you know if they're going to heaven?
Well, a lot of them are saved, so I'm not sure. I hope so.
Well, you need to find out.
No, because in the end, that would be it.
Yeah, exactly. It's a very important. You need to find out. You need to ask them, just like I asked you directly. Just, hey, do you know for sure that you'll be in heaven? And if they don't know for sure, you need to share that same gospel message that I just preached to you today. That's what we need to do. Do you have a Bible?
Yeah, I have one.
Do you have a King James Bible?
I think so. I have one.
Okay, well, I would encourage you to pick it up and read it. Have you read it lately?
I read it. I read it. I don't read it every day, but I do read it.
Well, the Bible tells us man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. How often do you eat your meals? You eat 3 times a day, don't you?
Yes.
Well, I think we should also be reading our word, you know, at least 2 or 3 times a day as well. Because that's the only way you're going to grow in the knowledge of God. You know that Bible is a legal document? And so we're going to be held accountable on Judgment Day based off of every word that's written in there. So unless you understand that legal document in your lifetime, an average person lives 70, 80 years. If you haven't read that whole Bible in your lifetime, you know you're going to be held accountable for that. So I just encourage you to read God's word, study God's word, and share God's word. And that's the reason why God had you call me today. So you can.
Okay, I sure will.
All right. Well, I appreciate you taking the time to talk with me. You got my number. If you have any other Bible questions, I would encourage you to contact me. If you know any other Christians that you can fellowship with that can do a Bible study so you guys can learn the Bible, I would encourage you to do that, because that's what's most important. Not what we do in this world, but it's what we do for our eternal Father. It's what's going to last forever. All right?
Okay. Thanks a lot.
All right. God bless.
All right. Same to you. Thank you.